Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of XP Power after U.S.-based Advanced Energy Industries announced it had ended a potential takeover bid worth 468 million pounds. London-listed shares of XP Power slumped 15% in afternoon trading. Also in focus, shares of U.S. education tech company Chegg after it announced a restructuring plan that includes deep job cuts. The stock jumped 17% in pre-market trading. And we're also keeping a close watch on shares of Apple after JP Morgan analysts lifted their price target on the iPhone maker amid its AI-driven upgrades. Apple shares are up 0.5% before the bell.
Asian markets ended Tuesday trade mostly higher following the Wall Street rally overnight. The Nikkei 225 jumped 1% after the Bank of Japan Governor Kazuo Ueda signaled a potential rate hike in July. The ASX 200 also gaining 1% after the Bank of Australia kept its key rate unchanged as expected for a fifth straight meeting. Here at home, the local bourse returned from the long weekend, posting losses, with the main index sliding for a fifth straight session.
The top of mind concern of investors is really what's going to happen to the peso-dollar rate if and when the BSP delivers on the rate cut. Any rate cut is going to reduce the yield advantage of the peso assets. So if the peso deteriorates, then we can still expect the market to weaken. Like 6,300, 6,400, so sideways with a downward bias.
In notable stock movements in the region, Toyota shares rose 0.5%. That's as its chairman, Akio Toyoda, and nine other board members were re-elected Tuesday, with shareholders shrugging off concerns about governance and certification test scandals. The rollout of the Marcos administration's flagship infrastructure projects now seen going much faster. That's after the government issued on Tuesday the implementing guidelines for Executive Order 59, which aims to cut red tape in key infrastructure projects. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. signed EO 59 in April in a bid to accelerate his government's infrastructure drive. Anti-Red Tape Authority Director General Ernesto Perez says the EO shortens the processing time for certain transactions and limits the number of processing agencies from about 30 to around 12 to 18. The new guidelines could speed up the processing of around 30 to 50 infrastructure projects that are currently in the pre-implementation stage.
Yung delay dyan is really about documentary requirements from each and every agency involved in the permitting process. That's why at the core of EO 59 is to limit the requirements only to those identified under Section 2 of EO 59, and no other requirements should be imposed by any other agent unless they can justify it with a constitutional or legal basis.
Top Japanese parliamentarians commit to hire more Filipinos in crucial sectors such as elderly care. That's after a Philippine congressional delegation led by House Speaker Ferdinand Martin Romualdez held high-level discussions at the Tokyo Parliamentary Tuesday. Japan acknowledged the valuable contributions of Filipino healthcare workers in supporting their country's aging population. Romualdez, for his part, said he looks forward to promoting more economic cooperation between the two nations.